Hi, I'm Sara and I make art. And today I'm going to be reviewing the Vincent Pro canvas for Masterpiece Canvas and doing a demonstration of an underpainting for what's going to be a blue Morpho butterfly. But first, a little about this canvas. I decided I wanted to try this canvas after I heard the artist Stephen Bowman pretty much rave about it in a video. And I think if I can find that video, I'll link it in the description. I should point out that this canvas is acrylic primed, which is perfect for me because, as you know, if you watch my channel, I work in acrylic. This is from their Vincent Pro line, which is their less expensive, thinner spine canvas. They have a pricier one with a thicker spine. You could think of this canvas as studio wrap and the other canvas, which is called Monet Pro, as gallery wrap. I almost forgot to mention I've made a video about the differences between gallery wrap canvas and studio wrap canvas. There'll be a link to that in the description. This is a linen canvas, and I'm reading this right now off of Dick Blick's website, which is where I ordered this canvas from. Featuring archival quality Belgian linen, Masterpiece Art Fix acrylic primed linen canvas is great for acrylic paint. The canvas is primed by hand with two coats of acrylic-based primer for 12-ounce primed weight. Staple-free edges are perfect for frameless presentation, and folded corners with an uncut salvage allow for restretching if desired. A superior glue and groove bracing system eliminates the need for glue, staples, or other materials that prevent expansion of the entire frame. Canvas 16 inches by 20 and larger is cross-braced for additional strength and tension in the canvas and on the frame. Masterpiece Artfix acrylic primed linen canvas is available in two profiles, Vincent Pro 7/8 inch profile and a 5x16 relief in the bar face and canvas back, which is what I have, and again Monet Pro 1 1/2 inch profile with a 1/2 inch relief between the bar face and canvas back. And for you oil painters out there, Masterpiece also makes an oil primed linen canvas, also in the Artfix line. This brand also has something called the Elite Portrait Smooth Linen Canvas, which, while it's a bit pricey, I would be interested in trying it because you know I love to do portraits. Now, before this, for my last, I don't know, maybe couple dozen paintings, I used Frederick's Green Label canvas. And Masterpiece isn't going to replace Frederick's for me, but it might become an alternative. For me, I don't think either canvas is better than the other, but I will say something that is kind of that's in Frederick's favor that is against Masterpiece is that, as far as I can tell, Masterpiece doesn't come in nearly as many varieties as Frederick's. It's more firm than pretty much any other type of canvas I've worked on. It's not rough, because it's a linen canvas, but it seems to be stretched more tightly around its frame than other canvases. I want to make sure to talk a bit about the actual painting that I'm doing. If you see this big metal thing come up, that's the airbrush. And I'm spraying water on this canvas to keep my paint wet. And you'll see me take a little fluffy brush, which is called a mop brush, and blend out edges. I remember at one point deciding that one shade I'd use wasn't quite light enough and I wanted it to be even lighter, like almost white, so I went over it. I'm only getting as far as the underpainting this week. Next week I'll be showing you how I put the color on this thing. You're going to see me take a charcoal pencil and draw in details over what I blocked in, drawing the scales specifically. And if you're wondering why I'm using the pencil to draw instead of just going straight on with paint, I made a video about that called Why I Draw Over My Painting with a Pencil, and I think I might put a card up about that, but I'll definitely link it in the description. But for the most part, while I was working on this painting, I didn't find myself thinking a whole lot about the canvas, but just concentrating on what I was working on, and I think that's a sign of a good canvas. Getting back to what I said about blending out the edges with a mop brush, I want to say that this is in the underpainting stage, and I don't normally worry about that at this stage of the painting. But because I want this to be iridescent, the creature that I'm painting is called a blue Morpho butterfly. And it's known for its very shiny, very iridescent blue color. I want that to show in the painting as much as possible. So I feel like even though it's in the underpainting stage, it's important to blend out those edges because any harsh edges are going to prevent the iridescence from showing. If it turns out when I add the color, if the edges weren't blended in the underpainting stage, then it'll be too late to go back and blend them. I felt a real sense of satisfaction after I finished painting in those scales with the liner brush. I feel like at that point that I could see the butterfly appearing before me. That's why I encourage you to step back from your work and just look at it every once in a while. Not only because it helps you judge things better than when you're right up close to it working on it, but because you might actually find that it's just enjoyable seeing how it's coming together. I'm looking at a picture of the painting on my screen as I do this voiceover, and I can see that the left side, or the right side if I'm looking at it, looks very shiny, but the left side not so much, and I think I need to put more lighter shades on the left-hand side of the butterfly's wing, or I should say on the butterfly's left wing. You know, there's no actual blue pigment in the blue Morpho butterfly. The blue color is caused by the structure of the butterfly scales, and the reason I know this is thanks to a video from Veritasium called How to Make Color with Holes, and I'll link that video in the description at the timestamp where he starts talking about the butterfly. It was from that video that I actually found out about the blue Morpho butterfly in the first place. The texture of the scales was created by putting different shades of white and black and different shades of gray all next to each other using a liner brush. For some of those lines, I barely touched the tip of my brush to the canvas because I wanted them to be as thin as possible. I would say that knowing how to use a liner brush is not only helpful for something like this, it's pretty much essential. I made a video about how to use a liner brush, and if you haven't seen that, it'll be linked in the description. Right here is a perfect example of when I want to make these lines just as thin as I can possibly make them. Which, by the way, I'm super glad I was able to do. Because having that much control over my lines, it's not something that was always so easy for me. You can see the wings are kind of lopsided, but not to worry. I'm going to fix that by shading in a very dark gray color in between the wings. This is going to be a U shape. The sides of this gray shadow area, I guess, are going to be almost hugging the butterfly's body. For the body, I started by just making little shapes in a light gray color, going along the sides in a pattern that I saw in my reference photo. Then I took my liner brush again, and using a very dark shade of gray, painted very thin lines in between where I had just painted those shapes. Then I mixed a shade of gray that was in between the color that I had used for my shapes and the color that I had used for my lines, and painted that right over where I just painted my very dark line. It was a combination of all of these, the light colored shapes and dark and light lines, that created this segmented look that the body has. If you're wondering why I've done this much work so far and the guy still has no antennas, that's because the antennas are very thin and they would be impossible to paint around. So I'm waiting till after I paint the flower that he's on, and then I'm going to paint the antennas over that. Here I thought I was done painting those scale lines, but it turns out I wasn't. I'm painting these light and dark patches. I'm not blending out the edges this time because these are going to be actual spots on the butterfly's wings. I had a lot of fun painting the head for some reason. Looking at it, I see that I'm going to have to adjust some things. I'm going to have to make those black things in the sides wider to get the shape right. But painting it was just a matter of painting lines and shapes and putting them in the right places. I should also point out that layering the slightly lighter gray on top of the very dark, almost black shade that I'd used for the sides of the head was important in bringing out that dimension. I already talked about this when I was talking about painting the body, but you can see here I'm going back and painting some lighter highlights, I guess, over my darker lines, and that, again, just gives it more dimension. For the flower, I used pretty much just my small round brush and my liner brush and made little curved marks. Actually, no, I used those for the marks, but I used the larger filbert brush to paint the larger patches, I guess, that those lines would go on top of. And here I'm painting one of those larger patches right now. Bringing out that liner brush again, but I'm putting more of it on the canvas so that the lines are thicker. And I sprayed those with my airbrush and blended out the edges with my mop brush to create this fuzzy look. I think the painting I'm working on would have been impossible to do without having the airbrush to be able to mist water on the paint, because if I put paint down, if I don't spray it with the airbrush, by the time I get my mop brush ready to blend out that line, that paint is already too dry for me to blend it properly. I'm really happy with the way these have turned out, especially using the airbrush. I don't know what you call it, but I'm painting this little thing on the guy's head in between his antennas. I make videos with art demos and tips every week, so if that sounds good to you, please subscribe and let me help you bring out your creativity.